Hi, my name is Ryan Marinelli, and I am a Journeyman Substation Technician for the Upper Peninsula Power Company. I have been a Journeyman Substation Technician for the last 10 years. I went through a 4-year, 8,000-hour apprenticeship to get to the point I am today. Within the apprenticeship, there's a lot of different skills that we've learned, anywhere from greenfield site construction, maintenance, and commissioning. So there's a lot of really good things that we do throughout the day and throughout the year that keep the job interesting. So we typically start our day right now, since COVID's happening. We have a morning meeting call-in where myself, the rest of my group, and our manager for a substation department, we talk about what we're gonna be doing throughout the day. After our meeting is done, we usually get out to our trucks, go through our PPE, make sure that we have all the stuff that we need to do our job safely throughout the day. We do a truck inspection, because these are DOT mandated trucks, make sure our tires are good, lights, brakes, all that kind of stuff. Also in the mornings, if we do need to restock our trucks, that gives us time. We can run over to our other shop, load up hand towels, any bolts, electrical tape, any of that kind of stuff that we're gonna need throughout the day. All of our trucks are fully stocked with pretty much every tool you can imagine. Since our day-to-day chores don't just include maybe working a computer, one day we could be working on a hydraulic system and a breaker. The next day we could be changing out a high voltage large power transformer. So pretty much our trucks are tooled up to do any job in any aspect of the substation, including new construction. Part of our morning routine is to inspect our PPE, which is our personal protective equipment. Right here what I have our, we classify these as low voltage gloves. This allows us with the sleeves to handle up to 1,000 volts with our bare hand or with our hands. Right here, these are our high voltage gloves. These are rated at 17,000 volts. So part of our inspection, you can see the inside of our gloves are red, outside's black. You roll these up, fill them with air, and we inspect between all the fingers, everywhere on the glove, to make sure we can't see any red. Because if there's a pinhole in this glove, that means that electricity can get through the glove and it can electrocute us. Also part of our PPE that we must wear in a substation are safety glasses and hard hats and steel toe boots. I'm gonna show you guys some of the tools and test equipment that we use daily. Since the substation department involves so much of the testing and maintenance, here's a couple of things. Right here is an underground fault locator. So if there's a bad cable underground, we can find that fault. Some days when we're working storm outages, we'll use a chainsaw. All of us substation technicians know how to weld, so a welder is part of our daily tool. This is one of our test sets that we use for testing breakers and transformers to inspect the health and integrity of them. And then everything on this shelf right here has a test equipment reason for something. So we could be right here, open this up. Here's a scope meter that we use, so we can check voltages and currents coming into substation relays. Here's some of our specialty equipment that we use in the substation department. This is our thermal imaging camera. So this, we go around every year to all of our substations and we look for hot spots in the sun. So if there's a connection point on the buswork that is heating up, we'll be able to see it with this camera. Also, one of the most important things that we have in our tool bag is our multimeter. This kind of lets us troubleshoot and do commissioning to a lot of different pieces of equipment. During construction, us subtechs work directly with the commissioning engineers. What we do then is we verify that all of the new work and wiring and components that we've installed are installed correctly, all the wiring is in its proper place, and that all the new controls and devices are functioning and work as they were designed to by the engineers. Today we're at the Northern Michigan University's Jacob Eddy Center. where they were nice enough to let us use their mock substation that they use to train up-and-coming substation technicians. We're gonna go through some of the equipment that they have in their mock substation to kind of give you a better idea how things work in a substation. So behind me is a circuit breaker. This is the first piece of equipment that will come in from where above us here would be where the line would come in from the transmission line in through the circuit breaker. The circuit breaker is just a protection device before it reaches the transformer here to my right. So what the transformer does is takes that higher voltage and then reduces it to a lower voltage to make the voltage more useful for us in our house so we're not having such a high voltage. Associated with the transformer, we're gonna have different types of switches so we can isolate it and we can do maintenance on it. As a substation technician, we can do a lot of different things. We could be doing the construction portion, on a greenfield site for brand new construction, maintenance. So that's what I do. I'm a maintenance technician. So we take these transformers out of service and test them, make sure that their life expectancy is as they should be and that they're in good condition. Also, as a substation technician, all of this steel work is something that we'd be responsible for installing. We do all the ground grid below us. Some of the equipment that we see here, we have switches before some of our equipment that we can isolate. That there is another protection device on the lower side of the transformer. That's called a recloser. From the recloser, it goes up through the switches and busware and out of our regulators, which is the three pieces of equipment to the left. So I'm inside the Jacob Eddy Center's mock substation. This is some of the controls that we have donated over the years that the students use to learn some of the control portion. As a substation technician, I do test these relays, both sides. These are the old electromechanical, and some of these are some of the new microprocessor stuff. As a substation technician, we do a lot of computer work. There's a lot of computer programs that we use to do the testing and maintenance. Some of the other things that we have here, these are some of the test equipment that the students are using to learn how to test this, the microprocessor relays. Right here is an example of a substation battery bank. We use these to provide power to our equipment inside the substation. As a substation technician, annually we do maintenance on these batteries. They are filled with electrolyte and acid, so we make sure that the level is good. We perform tests to see the condition of the overall battery. This is an example of one of the pieces of equipment that I may work on throughout the day. This is an older model, which is more mechanical. Some of the newer products will be more electrical based. A lot of the things that we work on are stored energy. There might be springs involved, hydraulic systems, magnetized systems. So it's a really interesting job to do day to day. We don't do a lot of the same thing twice. And every substation has a little bit of different pieces of equipment that we can work on throughout the day. I hope this video gave you some more insight as to what it means to be a journeyman substation technician and the work that we do to keep the lights on. If you're looking for a rewarding career that challenges you mechanically and electrically, I would recommend the journeyman substation technician program.